So in today's video, I'm going to show you exactly why Adobe Colour is a lot more useful and practical than you might think. Professional graphic designers and seasoned artists are really using Adobe Colour for their projects. And one of those people is Vastian, which you can see on screen right now in his work. He's a poster designer and I really do love his kind of style of work. And if you want to see me either collaborate with him or even maybe, you know, recreate one of his posters and show his techniques, just let me know down below. But today we are going to look at Adobe Colour and why it is so useful. Sponsoring today's video is Milanote, the best place to plan and streamline your next graphic design project. Milanote allows you to generate ideas and concepts with ease, and then to evolve those creations to final design solutions. As you probably know, I use Milanote myself for my design projects, and you can learn more about their awesome project planning software later in today's video, and just how helpful Milanote can be for your creative design process. So firstly, the basic and the main thing that you're going to find in Adobe Colour is that you can easily make colour schemes according to like analog, monochromatic, you know, complementary colours and so forth. It couldn't be easier to do, you know, you just pick a main colour, slide it around the wheel, and then Adobe will match that colour for you. Not only that, but you have the hex colour codes, and you can also change the colour mode itself to something like CMYK. Now that's really, really useful in itself, but that's not all I've got to show you today. There's a whole lot more that you can find in Adobe Colour, and we're going to find out right now. So firstly, if we head into my themes, you can see I've already made a theme for myself here, according to the Satori graphic branding, which you should know by now is purple. And I do love monochromatic colour schemes, and this is monochromatic. As you can see, I've got the hex colour codes, and also down below it will give me Pantone colours too, which sometimes don't work out too much depending on the settings and so forth. You can even give a name to your colour theme, which I'm going to do later. But also on the right hand side here, you can download and you can copy, and you can even like publish it and edit it and so much more. There's so much more options open to you on your actual libraries of colour schemes. So how do we add a colour scheme to our library? Let's head back to the colour wheel and let's make another monochromatic colour scheme, but this time let's go for a kind of earthy, sandy style colour scheme. Once you've made it, go ahead, give it a name, and simply save it to your library. And as before, you're going to have all the details and the data, and it's going to be there ready for you to use on your graphic design projects whenever you need it. The next thing about Adobe Colour is the Explore option, and this again is really, really, really useful. In the top search bar menu, you can type in things like colours, moods, keywords, you know, anything that's kind of relative to your project or whatever you have in mind. I don't know why, but I just chose the word dangerous to see what would happen, what would come up. As you can see, you've got pictures and you've got imagery, you've got illustrations, and you've got the colour schemes right down there below them. Directly from each thumbnail, you can either download or you can add it to your library. And that's a really, really, really good integration into Adobe Colour. But I'm not sure if that's Marilyn Manson on the right. But yeah, that is kind of dangerous and scary. But let's move on from that. On the right here, you can actually search by all sources, just colour themes, the creative projects, or just stock imagery. Now, one of the biggest and most useful advantages of Adobe Colour is the trends option. Now this is so useful because let's just imagine for a second we're making an app or a kind of a computerized game of sorts. If I come into here, I've got many different options that are available open to me with their relative colour schemes. If I come into this cat game here, it offers me a potential colour scheme as a kind of base to work with. Again, with the hex colour codes, the ability to add it to my library, and also the Pantone matches and stuff like that too. Do not neglect Adobe Colour because it's so useful for your graphic design workflow, and we all know that colour is very, very important in graphic design. And like I said at the start of the video, if you want to see me collaborate or maybe just work on a project relating to Vastian's work, do reach out to me or give him some love on Behance or Twitter and let him know that I want to collaborate with him because I think his work is really, really awesome. And I think we can make some good videos together. So yeah, do give him a shout from me, Tom Satori.
But yeah, big thanks to Milanote for sponsoring today's video. I really do highly recommend it, and I've been using it for nearly 2 years now myself. You can easily streamline your creative process from start to finish on any project that you're working on, but also it's very easy to share your ideas and your projects with other clients or even work colleagues. So yeah, do check out the links down below for more information on Milanote and start streamlining your creative design process in a more efficient way today.
Make sure you have a great day, everyone, and of course, until next time, design your future today. Peace.